Hi guys, welcome back. Crashlanding with me, Sid, and I've been busy, so let me show you what I've been up to between episodes. It's mainly all cosmetic-y stuff, but so the base is fully expanded as far as these walls will allow me to go. Hi, Mr. Spider. I've also installed a sound controller, and I've turned the mob noises down to 50%. Everything else is at normal volume. I have smelted some more metals. I've also been hammering gravel, and I've got some of that going on. And if I just come over here again, I've also got my first emerald, a whole load of redstone, certain quartz, glowstone stuff going on out here. Now out here, I have got rid of the generators. I realised that the generators were making me hot and making me sweat. So what I have done is I've taken the little spouty thing off of here. I have put a liquiduct in and a hopper. Now hoppers can be made the usual way, but we can also make them with aluminium. So I made a hopper with aluminium. That's feeding leaves into there. That is melting the leaves and putting the water into here. And finally, apart from I put a little bit of a parapet around here for some of this area. Haven't for all of it because I've got my orange tree there for the time being. I bricked over the entire courtyard and I have dug this. So now we can access all of these from beneath. So what was I after? Anything? Oat or note? Oh, I've got some cocoa seeds as well. So we'll go and add those to the tree. I sifted some sand as well, and that will come in handy. Whoa, hello. I don't think these shears are going to last very long. Oh, no, they didn't last very long at all. But 18, and that's better than a kick in the face. 19. So yeah, I'm really enjoying this mod pack. I'm enjoying both, actually, both this and Crafting Paradise for different reasons. This is much more of a battle for survival, as I'm sure you realise. Crafting Paradise, obviously, is a little bit easier on us. Now, was there anything in there that... I'll take the eggs out, I'll take the glowstone, take the certus, take the bone meal, salt... blah blah blah. Anything else? We can make that into a whole thing. We can make that into a whole thing. Enough there to make hole. Enough there to make hole. You know what? Bonk 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 bonk. That's gunpowder. We'll leave. Every salt we'll take. The lapis can come. That's it. Oh, and the coal. Yeah, got a lot of stuff coming out here. This is almost full of dust because obviously I've been digging out. I'm going to hollow out under the base that way as well. And then the entrance is going to come inside. I need a sapling, please. Thank you. Oh, there's some leaves hiding up there. Waste not, want not. Another two leaves. That's another point. Another 20% of a bottle of water. Which my water is looking pretty good at the moment. My food is a little bit dicey at times, but have I got any more dusts floating around? Yes, I'm kind of trying to sort out my inventory as well while we're going. Nothing there. Nothing there. And I don't think there's anything in either of these, so we can pop our redstone. Certus quartz in there. The lapis can go in there. Anything else? Nope. And then the foodie stuff can go here. What else was... Did I have anything else for food? Oh, eggs. That was right. So I've got some few fishes. I really need to eat something. What can I have? That's not been eaten recently. So we can have an orange juice and... We can start processing up some of this ore now. That's really nice. I could hammer this stuff down. Can't do that, can't do that, can't do that. But to be honest, I'm not going to waste the energy. I'm just going to work on these raw for the time being because every little bit up. Every little bit of water is going to count. Every little bit of food is going to count still at this stage, even though we're considerably more comfortable than we were. Okay, you can go in there. Like that. And that can go in there. So we've got a whole bunch of this stuff going on. Then we need... Now the bits I want is specifically is iron and nickel. Because today I want to up the ante a bit. I also want to see if I can pulverize this in the grinder. I know I couldn't do the dust. So... No, you can't. Okay, that's fine. Oh, another dirt, we'll have that. Okay, so... I'm going to... Oh, I've got a cup of tea in there. I'm going to cook up what we got. Iron. We'll set that one running. That's that running first. I'm going to go and put this... Oh, I've got a sapling. Yep, anything else hiding down there? No. Right. So this is actually working super well. Slow. Obviously with one actuator, but you know, it's not so slow that we can't work with it. What shall we plant there? Shall I stick a... I'll stick another... Blah, 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 what's it? What have I got? I'll stick another rice seed down, I think. For now. And... Yeah, water's running down fairly quickly at the moment, so I'll have a couple of bottles of water. It's not as fast as the Hoover, what do you call it? The fluid transposer, but it is free, so it's got a lot of advantages. Anyway, I'm going to... Oh, we've still got... I wanted to get... Where's my ferris gone? Let's get that running. I'm going to run these ores through and I will be back with you once we've got that done. Okay, we've processed that lot. My hunger's creeping up again. I think I am going to have... Oh, what shall we? What shall we have? Choices, choices. I think an apple juice. Let's do orange juices. Just for now. For the time being. Right, put these metals away. So I don't need the aluminium, don't need the lead, don't need the gold, do need the nickel, do need the iron, don't need tin, platinum, any of that. So one of the things, if you look at any thing, so if I just look at sword for example, if you look at the bottom of the tooltip there, an iron sword has been nerfed. It has a durability of 1, as does a wooden, as does a stone, as does a diamond and gold. Etheric sword, yeah, I don't think we're going to be anywhere near that. But if we look down here, an Imvar sword has got full durability. Now, normally, Imvar is a pain to make, because obviously you need lots of machines, but we can do it like this. I need to do, I think it's... 4 iron and 2 nickel, which is why I wanted the gravel. And we can just sit there and tip away at this, and eventually we should get iron dust. Yep, that's working. And we should also get nickel dust eventually. Now if you just AFK this, and well, not AFK, but you know, just sat here and spam that, you're probably going to break the wooden crank, which is not the end of the world. It's only wood, it's just sticks. So that should give us pulverized ferrous metal and iron dust, which we should be able to make into Imvar blend. That gives us 6 Imvar, which I've added some more furnaces in here. So let's just use a quick charcoal on that. So I think this is doing +6 attack damage, that does +6 attack damage, so there's actually no real benefit to the sword over the mattock, to be honest. But for shears, Well, that's a completely different ball game. So we've got normal shears, they've got 238 durability, precision shears from extra utility. I've got no idea how you make those, it's 1024. But Invar is just slightly under double the durability. Oh, into unstables and angel blocks. Yeah, I don't think we're going to be doing that anytime soon. So while we're waiting on that Invar to cook, let's just see where we are with regards to this. Silver ingots. Show me some silver. Detect. Now, the one to go for here is the leadstone thrusters, because we will have to go to the city eventually, and that will allow us to do what is necessary there. And this opens up a whole bunch of other quests, so moving things around. I've already made fluid ducts, item ducts, and leadstone energy conduit we need, and that will give us stuff. Let's get the Invar down. Let's see what else has opened up while we're at it. That is plastic sheets. Oh, printed circuit board. This is where we start getting into the old pneumatic craft. So that's there. We still need to kill some more zombies. And that is... Oh, and we still need to do that, which involves going over to the city, which I'm not anxious to do anytime soon. Under pressure, however, we have as well, and this is that we want some TNT for this, so we can probably start looking at those as well. Right, got me Invar. Let's make a pair of shears. Now I'm going to keep as much Invar as I can, because Invar armor. It's still quite loud, isn't it, while they die? So how do we use that again? It's leadstone, lead, and a leather strap. So that would allow us to make a jetpack, which we don't need right now. So we will put you away along with a hardened flux capacitor. We can put that and that away. What's my water like? Not bad. I'll go and get a couple of bottles of water to freshen up there. And let me sort that out. So, what's next on the agenda? Let's go and have a look. Well, a lot of it is going to be grindy, just seeing how much material we can make. And we've obviously got quite a bit of stuff coming through here. I will want gunpowder. And I'm going to need a hammer. Still got a bit of durability left in that old hammer there. I did plant that, didn't I? Yes. Oh, is that ready? Mature. Thank you. 50%, and you are mature. Thank you very much. Waste not, want not. And in this game, that is particularly true. What do I need? I need stock, a pot, and some rice. Rice soup, lovely. What's the 100% effective? Bang, in you go. Right, need some cobble. Got some there. And I'll just do myself enough to make one TNT for the time being. That's five. Is it five or so? Oh, sorry, we'll do a bit more, just to be on the safe side. So what we got to do is make some gravel. Now gravel is, in my opinion, still the best thing to sieve, because there's a chance of diamond. Now I have been reliably informed that diamond, I think it's that, isn't it? I'm sure it's more gunpowder. Yes. It is. Thank you very much. A bit of TNT. Second step. First step was iron. Second step was TNT. Third step is compressed iron, and that will give us compressed iron ingots. So I'm going to need sticks. If I were a stick, where would I be? Or am I completely out of wood at the moment? I'm actually completely out of wood. That's quite surprising. Right, let's go get some then. Grow, damn you. Thank you. Let me grab these, keep the water situation good. I think one of the hardest things I'm finding with this mod pack, once you got through the initial survival phase, because obviously that is probably the hardest bit, is remembering to really check absolutely everything. You know, keep your eye on your water, keep your eye on what food you're eating. I'm guessing I should have checked that actually, shouldn't I? Let me do that and that for now. Oh, I don't know, leaves. Yeah, it's just keeping your eye on the ball. Because normally Minecraft is very forgiving for, you know, the old... if you're not quite 100% monitoring what you're doing. And that is all good now. You do get some loss, so I'm gonna do 10. I'm gonna need a lot of this, so 10 is probably a good number. There was one other thing I wanted to do. Do the lot. Three should be enough. And have I got any more walls kicking around? Yes, lots of walls. The only thing is with that, every time I see those things popping up, it kind of startles me and I kind of think, oh my god, I'm being attacked by something. Oh dear, this is not looking good, is it? Oh, I'm out of ammo in there. Okay, that's not a problem. Come on then. Come on then. I don't know what you are. What are you? Oh well, it's extra food, whatever. Come on. Oh, you are tough, I think. Yes. Come on. Get up here. He is tough and all, isn't he? Right. Where are you now? You're down quite a bit. Come on. And one more, I think, should do it. Right, let me just have a quick peek around the edge. Looks clear, apart from this fella. Right, did I see... Oh, there's another one here. It's all food. Oh god, look at that. Okay, let's just I think most of the drops will have despawned by now. Looks that way. Let's just head out here. So we whack down our TNT. We whack down our lever. We throw down our iron. And stand back. And that should give us, what did we get there? 7, so we lost 3. That's not too bad a return. I will have this dust because it's here. Okay, I need to get back in, get undercover, and I need to just finish off my entrance, which is going to be here. Hup. And we will do that around the edge. That should give me adequate protection. Sound altogether quite profitable. Bit of spider's eye, some string, some more dust, which is always handy. And most importantly, oh, I need to go down now to do that, don't I? Better get some food in me as well. I'll have to deal with those creepers before I finish off my mob trap plan, because we're getting there steadily. I need to also make these walls look nicer, but that's hardly important at this stage. Okay, some food, please, monsieur. What have we got? Well, we've got spiderite, so I think spiderite stew is probably on the menu. Bit of stock. Spider's eye, is it a pot? Yes. Need to do another one of those, don't I? Stock and spider. In fact, why don't I just do that? You can go back. I need to do something with some of these other bits and pieces as well, but for now that will do us. And let's see what we got on there. So we are claimed the reward. So the next thing it wants is a pressure tube. Now I've already got lightning seed plants, I believe. Oh no, they're creeper seed plants. Oh. How do you get lightning seed plants? They're probably the one to go for then. Let me just have a check on these light. Lightning seeds make cyan with grass would make those. And we use those in there. I think the lightning seed plants might be the better one there. So how do we make pressure tubes? Pressure tube, iron bars. No, I want pressure tube. All right, two compressed and some glass. Have I got any glass? Very good question. To which the answer is no. I'll stick those in there for now. Right, I'm going to do some cobble hammering, cook up some glass, and I will be right back with you. Okay, got some glass. I've put cooked eight up, and I've put a bunch in the sifter to see if we can't get some interesting hoofadoofers. What's the word I'm looking for? Seeds. Seeds is the word I'm looking for. So that's four pressure pipes, which should take us to here, and then we need an air compressor. Oh, lovely. So an air compressor is... Air compressor is a pipe, a furnace, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I haven't got enough, have I? Oh, yes, I have got loads. 6 of these. And a furnace. We can do that, and we can do that now. Which is nice. Let's just go bang, bang, and make me one of those. Right, so out of these, lightning seeds, I've not seen lightning seeds, I'm not sure where I would get lightning seeds from. Before I pick this, let me just go and check up, see where they come from, and do a bit of research in the background, so I'll be back in a moment. Okay, made a quick research, and apparently lightning seeds occur when lightning strikes, and seeing as it doesn't rain... Oh, if it does rain, you know, I'm not seeing any lightning yet. I am going with the lightning seeds. So we'll claim that. So the next thing we need is a pressure gauge tube, which will give us 4 of those. Let's have a look at that one. Pressure gauge tube. So it needs that too, redstone and a pressure gauge, which is gold around that. Again, that's all doable. One of those. 4 of those, 2 of those, okay, gold around that, goes there with that, and then we have a bit of that going on, that gives us that one, claim that, pressure chamber wall, pressure chamber window, and a pressure chamber valve. Now this is where we're into... Squid plant seeds, again, until I get some grass seeds, are going to be a little bit hard to come by. You've still got a good full 100%, so we'll just munch that. So, we need pressure chamber wall is a few of those. Well, I think we can do those. Let me go and let's just grab everything we've got of that. I don't think we're going to be in a position to get a full pressure chamber going this episode, but pressure chamber windows, the same again with the glass in the middle. Okay, because and a pressure chamber valve is the same again with a pipe, and I'm now officially low on compressed iron. I've only got 6, so I need to get more iron going. We'll put you safely in there, along with those. And I'm going to have to process iron, I think, is the long and the short of it. To get anywhere close to completing that, let's have a look what we got. 24 iron, 3 crushed iron ore. Oh, more cocoa beans. Let's start emptying again. Oh, cactus seeds. That is absolutely brilliant. That is probably one of the best sources of water, because you don't have to do anything with it. You can craft cactus directly into water, I believe. Cocoa beans, I'm not going to plant those. I've got some already planted, so they can go in food, along with eggs and the salt. Okay, that lot needs to go, not that, and not that, that. I really do need to, oh, there we go. It's much easier with that. That's still loud, but I'm sure it's not as loud for you as it was. We'll have that back as well. Shuffle that lot together. Take those out. And that out. And that out. Oh, might as well, sorry, have the lot out. Okay. So I think I'm going to just check on my recording time, because I'm not entirely sure where I am with that. I also need, bang, have a look, how with Ryan now? 24, not really enough. I'd like to detonate a stack of it, to be brutally honest. So I'll probably go and process up a whole load of iron. That's the wrong chest. Okay, glowstone, redstone, surface. That can go in there as well. As can the blaze powder. I really do need to sort out my chesticles a wee bit. Oh, there's some lead there. So I'm going to check how long I've been recording, and also where we are in terms of what, and I will be back with you in a short while. Okay, I decided it's time to clear my trench out. The mob griefing off isn't perfect here, by the way. As you can see, that wasn't good. Alright, so I need to plug that up for starters. Let's get down here and grab what bits of loots we can get that hasn't burnt up. Water's okay, food isn't brilliant, and there's no creepers in sight, which is perfect, just the way I like it. So one thing I obviously do need to do is fix up this wall a bit. Where's my chisel? Bonk. I'm also running quite late time-wise. So what I'm going to do is just do this in terms of... Oh, I'm near the lava. I was just wondering why I was sweating, but of course the lava's just on the other side of that wall, isn't it? Yeah, so time-wise, I am running a bit later than I would have liked. So I'm going to just do a little bit of work on the trench here, and I will be right back with you. Okay, I've still got one side of the trench to work on, but the other two I have widened, well, all of them I've widened to, don't know whether I'm safe here, too wide, and I've stone lined them, so they should be creeper blast proof. The other side I do need to do, but just to finish off this episode, I am going to plant a lightning seed. Now, I am not entirely sure what this does, but I am guessing that when it's ripe, it doesn't seem to do anything, but we can get them back. That's good. Pneumatic craft seeds are weird because you... Oh, hello. You've grown finally, have you? Because you throw them on the dirt and they plant the cells. So I know the creeper ones, when they're ripe, explode. The squid plants explode squids out, believe it or not. Beyond that, I'm not sure what the other ones do, but I'm sure we will find out together in the future. Oh dear. Give me some of that, please. Not that. That, please. Let's stick these. What's my water situation like? Okay at the moment. Stick those in. That's still got plenty in it. That's full. So the world is looking pretty good so far. We need to probably get a cactus farm running sometime sooner rather than later, and get some of these pneumatic craft seeds going. I've moved the steps in here and expanded this a little bit, and I've got basically... Oh God, listen to that. I've got basically a whole bunch of things dying out there now. Now it may be possible, if we're lurky... Oh, hello. Get dead. Right, where is the other one? And you. Now what we got left in here? A whole bunch of creepers. Blow up. Well, I need to fix that. Oh, come on. There's one way to deal with them. I wouldn't recommend that way normally, and hopefully once we've got this all set up correctly... Oh God, I want to really kind of lure all of these down this way if I can, so we can get them drops. Now, it's a little bit easier to manage this though, like this. So come on, creepers. Hello. Oh crap. You got to pull the zombies out. what have we got? Some zombie jerky. Hello. Don't you blow up there. You're too close to the drops. Just need to keep them away from all these lovely, lovely drops down here. Oh, more zombies. Oh, plague zombie in armor. Come along, follow me. Come along, children. We're going to the zoo. Any more? No, you're all there. Good, good. Come on, then. About the best way I found to deal with these is to detonate... Oh, God. Stupid creepers. Oh, crap. Oh, now we've got little babies. Come along, children. Try keep up this time and don't blow up until I'm ready. Thank you. Clear. So that is how I clear the trench at the moment. It's not brilliant, but it does at least keep me in rotten meat. I've got the, obviously got the rest of this to do. Just line it out. I think I may have, oh, I might be a bit short on cobblestone. I might have to go and grab some quick. But yeah, just to finish up by saying, I am going to do a live stream of this weekend on Sunday. I will put a normal full announcement up later on. Let me just go and grab some cobble while I can. And I think we're in a better situation. We're in the situation now where we can actually take our time and work on things rather than the constant mad scrabble for, you know, just resources, like just things as simple as water, you know, were a major thing. So we are in a much better situation now. I know one of the quests, it does require me to go to the city at some point, which is over that way. I have to say, I am not in a hurry to do it. I think going early just to get the Tinker's Construct tools and stuff would be an exercise in futility, really. Because from what I have read and what I've seen, most people, that is where the deaths get them after this stage. Now, there are anybody who watches me, or anybody, if you've watched me for a while, you know my watchword is caution. You know, take things steady and don't take unnecessary risks. Oops. Also, use the right tool for the right job is also quite a good watchword. So yeah, I'm not in a hurry to do that. I'm quite happy to start building up the base. I've got a little bit of a cactus farm going up here. I think I will build a proper cactus farm underground, under this level. I'll probably go down a level. But before that, I desperately want to, I need to sift a hell of a lot of sand. Because I need rubber tree saplings for my plant. And I believe sand is the only place I can get it. Let me just have a look. Sand. Show me the sifting. Exnihilo. Oh, hang on. Use. Get the right option. Probably going a little bit over here. Yeah, we have... Oh, or is it dirt? Maybe I have to sift dirt. Oh, that's probably why I'm not seeing anything. Dirt. Use. Oh, no. Dirt. Yeah, use. Rubber tree. So we're sifting. There's a 2% chance of rubber tree sapling, so I need to get a lot more dirt going. Right, but I desperately need the rubber trees, so I will probably be sifting dirt for a while to try and get those going. But until next time, thanks for watching, guys. I probably rambled on long enough, and I will see you on the live stream. Bye for now.